This week is one of the most important weeks of your life, right? There's no room for error, no room for mishaps or mistakes. Got it? You need to be perfect. No. You are perfect. I am perfect. There's nothing in my way, not even that.
Snake, who thinks she can steal this opportunity from me. She's been there, following me like a shadow our whole lives. At every turn, she's been right there, trying to make a fool of me.
Well, not this time. I don't care how many awards she's won or how flawless her grades are. I'm just as good as her. No, I am better. So much better.
And if she thinks for one moment I'm going to let her worm her way into the one thing I have left, the one thing that could be mine, not ours, mine, well, she's out of her goddamn mind.
Just a few more days. I just have to make it through this week and it will all be fine. I'll move far away from this town and more importantly, far away from her. It will be...
perfect.
Good morning, Luna. How are we feeling today?
A bit nervous, perhaps? If I remember correctly, you're planning on embarrassing yourself in front of the Stinton's admissions board later this week. Am I right? What a shame it'll be when you're rejected. Personally, I'd hate to waste the committee's time, but I guess not everyone grows up learning basic manners.
Why, grief, it isn't my favorite pretentious bitch. I knew I was going to say something this morning, but I
wonder, do you ever get tired of living in my shadow?
Because it must be exhausting trying to prove yourself over and over again and always falling short.
Oh, ouch, I'm so hurt. You've really shown me the errors of my ways. I swear I will repent and maybe, just maybe, I'll be able to shove a stick as far up my ass as you have.
Sure. One can only hope. Well, I have more important things to do, but I'm sure I'll see you later. And thank you for the riveting conversation.
Good luck on your interview. Try not to break down into an emotional mess. I hear it's not a great look.
Doing?
You seriously can't be civil for 1 minute? Any other day, you throw your half-ass insults at me, and I pretend to care, and we have our stupid little banter, but please, please, for God's sake, can we call a truce? Just this once. This interview is clearly important for both of us, so can you try not to ruin it?
Me? You're suggesting I'm the one ruining it? You've been trying to sabotage my chances of getting into Stinton all week.
Are you kidding me? You were the one who just started with these weird pranks to try and throw me off.
I was only being fair by returning the favor. It's not like I wanted any of this. You know, you don't have to be so perfect all the time. Everyone already knows you do everything right, that you're better than all of us. You don't need to shove it in our faces.
What do you mean, I am better than everyone? Why can't you see yourself? God, you barely have to try and you're so perfect. You know, it's not like that for everyone. It really isn't. Not everyone is talented like that. Some of us, we have to put in extra work just to be average.
Luna, you can't be serious. You're so much better than average.
Luna D'Angelo Lark? Is there a Luna D'Angelo Lark?
Yeah. That would be me.
You did this. This is all your fault. You fucked up my week with your twisted mind games, and now you fucked up my entire life. Just when I thought I could finally have something that was mine, that no one, not even you, could take it away from me. You took matters into your own hands and destroyed everything, just like you always do. You know, I get you grew up poor or whatever, but you don't have to make it everyone else's problem.
What the heck are you talking about? This is my fault? You are the one who started this week of fucked up craziness. You are the one who couldn't play fair. You're the one who chose to do anything in your power to win this pathetic competition. I was just playing along, okay? Literally. Fuck you. You could have chosen any school. Why did you have to pick one? This one, why is it so goddamn important for you to go to Stinton? You see, I take chances away from you. You have everything.
You don't get it, okay? You could never understand. It wasn't a choice. It was an expectation. How am I supposed to get them to notice me?
Who the fuck are you talking about? Don't tell me you mean your parents. Oh my God. Oh my God. You did this so you could get your parents to notice you. Newsflash, they don't give a fuck and they never will. It's not to someone.
Oh, fuck you! Why are you even upset? You won, right?
How stupid are you? Huh?
I didn't get it either, okay? And unlike you, I have no other options. I can't just take some of Daddy's money and pay off anyone who gets in my way. I could only afford one admissions fee, and I took a risk. A risk I never should have taken. I had this dream of going to that school. I thought that I had a stupid little fantasy that if I went to Stinton, I could beat the odds and be just like Jack Clue. I did this for myself, not to anyone else. And you took that chance away from me, not the other way around.
You know what?
I pity you.
You put on this facade that you're so much better than everyone else. But we all know where you come from. We all know that you live in the dirt because your parents couldn't get themselves together enough to provide for your family.
Well, at least I have a family that wants me.
I'll be back, ladies. Just keep doing what you're doing.
I just wanted to say that I was gonna say, I wanted to say I'm sorry. Look, I've been thinking about it, and you're right. I did start this. It's no one's fault that we didn't get in, but I didn't think about how this could end for you. I was just so caught up trying to get my parents to finally see me that I forgot your life would be affected by this too. I guess I never really learned to think of others like that. I always had to fend for myself. And I'm sorry for that. I'm sorry for ruining my life and taking you down with me. You know, I've always admired you for putting other people first. You're always so kind and thoughtful. Something I don't think I'll ever be. Oh, come on, Luna. I'm practically pouring my heart out here. You can't even look at me?
Bree, I don't care about this school shit anymore, okay? Everyone with a brain knows that you shouldn't put all your eggs in one basket. No offense. I've spent all these years trying to show you up because I just wanted everyone to stop looking down on me. Whenever I walked through these halls, I felt a sea of eyes watching me, judging me.
because my shoes were falling apart or because my jeans were three sizes too big. I wanted to be noticed for who I am, not where I come from. I wanted for people to look at me the way they look at you. I wanted you to like me. You know that I never had a real friend. I spend so much time trying to be perfect that I forgot to be a kid.
You know what? I'm tired of trying to be perfect. I think it's time we learn to live a little. Let's get out of here. No more judging eyes or absent parents. Just you and me. Let's be free. Let's do something fucking crazy.